If you will procure me the best shoes for my horse, and the most magnificent saddle and bridle that can be found, said the youth, you may all have my 12 mares, just as they are standing out on the hill, and their 12 foals into the bargain. For this year also each mare had her foal. The brothers were quite willing to do this, so the lad got such shoes for his horse that the sticks and stones flew high up into the air as he rode away over the hills, and such a gold saddle and such a gold bridle that they could be seen glittering and glancing from afar. And now we will go to the king's palace, said Dapplegrim, because that was the horse's name, but bear in mind that you must ask the king for a good stable and excellent fodder for me. So the lad promised not to forget to do that. He rode to the palace, and it will be easily understood that with such a horse as he had, he was not long on the way. When he arrived there, the king was standing out on the steps, and how did he stare at the man who came riding up?
Nay, said he, never in my whole life have I seen such a man and such a horse.
And when the youth inquired if he could have a place in the king's palace, the king was so delighted that he could have danced on the steps where he was standing, and there and then the lad was told that he should have a place. Yes, but I must have a good stable and most excellent fodder for my horse, said he. So they told him that he should have sweet hay and oats, and as much of them as the dappled horse chose to have, and all the other riders had to take their horses out of the stable, that Dapplegrim might stand alone and really have plenty of room. But this did not last long, for the other people in the king's court became envious of the lad, and there was no bad thing that they would not have done to him if they had but dared.